You have spent so much time publishing your content that when it comes time to actually promoting it, you're completely burnt out. Sound familiar? Don't worry, there is a better way, and in this video, I'm showing you how to set up a content bank to make sure you're maximizing the ROI from every single piece of content you create. Welcome back to my channel, Empire Builders, and if you're new here, my name is Haley Dale, and I am a content and sales funnel strategist helping you create more purposeful, productive, and yes, profitable content too. So if that sounds like something you're looking for, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below this video for more value-packed videos just like this one every single Monday. If there is just one thing that I could convince more people to start using and setting up and having in their business and for their content, it would be the content bank. It is my favorite tool ever because it helps you avoid some big content no-nos, including forgetting what you've created. Tell me you have not been there before. I know I have because I create so much content that I'm like, did I create a blog post on this? Did I create something on this? I don't actually know. And then the second thing that it helps you do is make sure that you are promoting your content. So my general rule of thumb is that for every amount of time that you spend creating a piece of content, I want you spending at least as much time promoting it. Ideally, we'd be more in a 2-to-1 ratio scenario, but if you're just getting started and you're like, I barely promote my content as it is, let's just start with the 1-to-1 ratio. The way that this helps is because when you are, like, say, needing to take a week off or you find yourself not able to maintain that 1-to-1 ratio, what we can do instead is scale back on the new content you're creating, and you can go to your content bank, find a piece, promote it, and then you're hitting closer to that 1-to-1 ratio. But it doesn't just help you prevent mistakes. It also helps you take advantage of some major opportunities when it comes to reusing and repurposing your content too. That is the first thing, repurposing. So say if you need to come up with a new blog post, or say you need to create something big like a course or a book or a freebie, you can go and shop your content bank first and pull pieces that you've already created so that you're not starting to create that new thing from scratch. It also helps you get some much needed R&R. As business owners, we can fall into that trap of work, 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 work. What is a vacation? I don't even know anymore. So when it comes to taking a break off, like taking some time off your business, one of the biggest things holding people back is feeling like, oh my gosh, if I disappear, if I don't send out a newsletter this week, if I don't send out my blog post this week, people are going to forget about me. And so one of the things you can do when you want some time off is you can pull from, let's again, shop from that content bank instead of creating something new, and you can make that your new post for the week that you want to take off. But perhaps the biggest thing is I want you to start viewing your content as a body of work, as your legacy. So as content creators, as business owners who create content to grow our businesses, we are infusing our content with the best of our ideas and our processes, that they really become a representation of us that live on, like even after we've maybe stepped away from the business or we're focusing on something else, those pieces of content continue to cement that legacy we have, cement those ideas and cement that process we have. And again, we shouldn't always have something new to say. So if you find yourself like feeling like you are on this never-ending content creation hamster wheel, setting up a content bank can help you start to view your content and view all of the content you've created as a like cohesive body of work and knowledge, and start to see it as something that you are building, and it's not going to go on forever and ever. So starting really to view that as your legacy, view that as a body of work, helps you to start to see that you shouldn't be creating content on end and end. And if you are running out of topics, you should go back to the beginning of stuff you've already created. We shouldn't always have something new to say, because our signature processes as business owners, the body of work that we represent, doesn't always change. Yes, there are updates. Yes, there are new things in the industry, but our processes shouldn't change from week to week or month to month. Then we're just creating whiplash, not only for ourselves, but for our audience as well. So what is a content bank? I hear you're like, you have convinced me to use a content bank, Haley, but what the heck is it even? So I think of a content bank as an inventory or a library of all of the content you've created in the past. Generally, it's organized by content type, so be it blog posts, videos, freebies, social media posts, emails, etc. But it is really that inventory where you can go and find any piece at your fingertips of things that you have created. So before we get started, I want to talk about how to set up your content bank. And before we begin, you may want to go through, if you're feeling like your content is all over the place, you may want to check out my content organization process, which I will link to. It's a blog post that I wrote last year, and it is a great blog post for helping you organize your content and start feeling like it's all in one place. So definitely go and check that out. I will put it the link below. And then the second thing we need to do for building your content bank is we need to choose where you're going to build it. So our key characteristics of a good content bank tool is that it is, you know, more of a board style. Also that we can search things and filter things, put tags on things. So we can search it not only by title, by date, but also by category. So we can put labels on it as well. So some of the most popular options would be things like Trello, Asana, Airtable, just a Google spreadsheet. But the first thing you want to do is make that choice. So where is that going to be for you? Is there a tool that you're already using that this would be a nice natural extension of? Then what I want you to do is go and set up that space, and I'm going to walk you through how to do that. There are two main types of tools. So you're either going to have the spreadsheet option or the board option. And your process for setting it up is going to be a little bit different depending on which option you have chosen. So let's go through, if you were setting up a board-based content bank, what you will do to set that up. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is you're going to want to set up a list. So a list within the board. So we're thinking like a Kanban board or a Trello board, which you can also use in other tools like Trello or ClickUp. And then you're going to want to set up a list for each type of content. So that might be, here are all my blog posts, here are all my videos, here are all my paid courses and paid offers, because I have like promo copy related to that. Here are all my freebies. So just set up that basic structure first of the types of content. So we want a list for each. Then for each of those types that you've put down, I want you to create a sample card. So boards, we add the little cards to them, and I want you to set up a card for one of each of those different types. So each board, by the time, each list in your board, by the time you're done this step, should have one piece of content added to it. And we want to set that up as a template so we have a model to follow for the rest of them. So some of the pieces of information that you want to make sure each card has about the pieces of content is the name, the last date shared or published, the link to the published piece, so where people can access it, any promo copy, any promo images, as well as a link to the file in your digital filing system. So once you have your sample cards in each of those lists, I want you to pick one type of content to go through and build from start to finish. So you're going to go and finish all of your blog posts, then all of your freebies, all of your videos, all of your paid offers, but go one by one and finish it all the way through before moving on to the next, unless you have a ton of content, in which case stick with me. I have a couple of tips for you. But first, let's talk about setting up if you've chosen more of a spreadsheet-based tool to host your content bank in. Basically, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to set up a tab. So instead of rows for each piece of content or columns for each piece of content, we want to think about tabs for each type of content. So this is going to be, you're going to have a tab for all of your blog posts, all of your freebies, all your videos, your paid offers. That way, all of the pieces of content that are of that type will live in one tab. So first steps first is set up a tab for each content. Then what I want you to do is in your header row, put down the bits of information that you want to collect for each type of content. So some of the most important ones to have here is like date published or date last shared, the name of what it is, the link to the published piece, a link to an item, the folder or something in your filing system, promo copy, promo images. You may also want to put down a category here or if there's any connections to other pieces of content. Then what I want you to do after you've done that, put just like before with the board-based one, once you have your header row, I want you to go and collect one of each of the types of content that you've set up tabs for. So make sure you go and put down one blog post. So fill out everything for one blog post, fill out everything for one freebie in the freebie tab, fill out everything for one of your paid offers in the paid offer tabs, your videos, etc. However many types you have, fill out one row because we want to use that as an example for all of your other pieces. Then just like before, you're going to pick one type of content and build it all the way out. So continue until you've finished adding all of your content within one type. So you might do all all of your blog posts, then all of your videos, then all of your paid offers. But I really want you to start, like, finish one completely. Just like before, if you have a ton of content, I have a tip coming up for you in a second. But I want to just show you some different setups. So I'm going to be sharing my screen here and showing you some different things. So the first type here is Trello. And this is a template that I have available for you. But as you can see here, it is set up in the different rows, just like I talked about. We have the different types here. And then we also have, like, more of a legend where you can put down, like, your different categories and stuff like that, so you can easily find it. Then we have Asana. So I have also set up a content bank in Asana. And this is a tool. The reason I set it up there versus Trello, so I have, like, pretty much set up content banks in all of these different types. So Asana, the reason we set it up there, we thought that was going to be the option for us, is because I'm already using Asana for all of my different tools. And so setting up my content bank in Asana made sense because that's where we were most of the time. Then our other option here is Airtable. So if you're an Airtable kind of content creator, business owner, you can also set this up in Airtable. So this is more of a spreadsheet based option. And just like before, you'll have different tabs, like you can see here, for each of the different types. So I have blog post, I have the different types as well. And then the final thing, the most simple option, if you're not sure about where you want to build this right now, I would recommend starting with a spreadsheet. So in the spreadsheet here, just like with Airtable, I have different tabs for different types of content, and I'm just pulling in the most relevant pieces of information. And I went over what were the recommended ones to make sure you have in terms of information for each piece of content, but definitely take this and tailor it for you. The biggest key here is to find the tool that works for you, whether that is something that just fits the way you think, or whether it's something that, like, you're already in that tool a lot of times, and so being there makes sense because you're already in there for your project management tool or for other things that you do in your business all the time. So just a couple of tips here, because I know you might be overwhelmed. If you have created a ton of content, you're like, whoa, this is a beast of a project. So if you have a ton of content, just know you don't need to do this all at once. You can start with your most recent posts. So say you just want to do within the last year to date, I'm going to go and grab all the blog posts, all of the freebies, all of the videos that I put out. Then you can work backwards. So you don't need to tackle this all at once. Start with the most recent, use it going forward, and then you can start to build out the past content as well in your content bank. If you are overwhelmed, just start with one category, build out all your blog posts, and then in a month or two, you can start with your freebies. You can start with your paid offers. So you can also just start with one category if you're feeling overwhelmed. Anything that you put in is going to be better than not having anything at all. So even if you need to do it in a little by little approach, that's totally okay, and that totally works too. Now, in terms of options, like I said, you could add more info too. So I said include the name, the date published, the link to it, the folder link, etc. But think about what information that you would like to have. An example here is for my freebies, I build out lead boxes for pop-ups for all of them. And in that content bank, I also have the code for that pop-up, so I never have to go into lead page again and find it. It's something that we can just copy and paste from the content bank if we want to add it to another blog post. So customize this to you. What are other pieces of information that you are going to find useful and is going to save you time when you're looking for information related to that piece of content? My second biggest tip here is, if you are unsure about what tool you want to use, whether that's Asana or Trello or Airtable or ClickUp or something else, use a spreadsheet as a base. So the reason why using a spreadsheet or a Google Sheet works best as a base is that it's very easy to move to another tool if you have it in spreadsheet format. So most of the tools have an importer option from a CSV, which is an exportable file option from a spreadsheet. You can export it as a CSV, so comma separated values, and you can upload that to Trello. You can upload that to Asana and have those pieces of information put in there. So having it as a base, so a spreadsheet as a base, can save you a lot of time if you're not sure, because you can go and try Asana. And then because you have that spreadsheet, it's not like you're starting all over from scratch and rebuilding again when you want to move to Trello or you want to move to Airtable. So it just makes your content a bit more portable until you are ready to commit to a specific tool. So have I convinced you to start a content bank yet? Give me a like on this video if yes, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. And if you want more videos like this one, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and you can click on the video next on your screen.